Right, what I have here is a collection of monitors. It's my Samsung SyncMaster 900P, my Dell monitor, and another small Dell monitor that's just behind my back, because it's all about KVM switches. Well, my Pentium 2 has been restored a little bit. We had some problems with the capacitors on the motherboard, and we kind of repaired it, and at the same time I dug up an old Pentium 4 computer from the attic, and I thought it'd be cool to use a KVM switch. So what did I do? I bought this really cheap cable KVM switch, and it works fine, except it's not compatible with the Samsung monitor. But it works just fine with the other monitors. So let's take a look at the setup. Right here is a really small Dell monitor that I once picked up at a thrift store. There's the Samsung CRT, and there is a big Dell display that I use with my modern computer. And the KVM switch itself is really quite nice. So here are the two computers. On the left is the Pentium 4. It uses an ASUS P4P800 motherboard. It dates from 2004. And on the right is of course my Pentium 2 that has been restored a little bit. Yeah, and now onto the KVM switch. I'll take the camera off the tripod now. So this is the actual KVM switch. It's a very simple device. The model name is quite generic, as you can see. These are sold under different brands, but this particular brand is called Argus, and they are sold under many different brands. It's very simple. It switches video, audio, mouse and keyboard, and it's one of the few that also does audio, which I think is really neat. Well, and at the back of the computer it just looks like this. You got that cable over there, you got that cable over there. It looks a little bit messy, but that's how it works. And as you can see here on my Samsung monitor, it says check signal cable, even though it's plugged in. But this monitor does not like the KVM switch at all. But it works just fine with the other monitors. Let's try the small Dell monitor now. And presto, there we have MS-DOS on the Pentium 2. And well, I just have to press Ctrl 2 times on the keyboard to switch to the Pentium 4 computer. Bingo, there we have Windows XP. We could even try a game like Splinter Cell. And as you can hear, the audio is quite nice as well. And maybe we'd want to go back to DOS. Very simple, just like that, two presses on the control key. And now we're back into Splinter Cell again. So that works all just fine and dandy. Now let's try the big monitor. And bingo, there you have it. KVM switch works just fine with the big Dell monitor. No problems whatsoever. But now if I plug in the Samsung again, it will remain this way. It will always say check signal cable. It would just think it's not receiving any signals. I think it just has something to do with the weird VGA shenanigans, because VGA is kind of a weird standard, and yeah, KVM switch works fine with more modern LCDs, but it doesn't seem to work with the CRT, so let's try it. And as you can see, I switched the signal cable, but nothing's happening. And yes, it is plugged in at the back of the monitor. That's not a problem, but yeah, it just doesn't seem to receive it. Really strange. That's a little bit disappointing, but just be aware of that when you buy KVM switches, that some monitors do not really cooperate with them. So there you have it. That was a really short and really impromptu and kind of off the cuff video, just kind of random about KVM switches. I might get into a little bit more detail about that Pentium 4 computer at some point in the future. It's really interesting. It has a rather odd motherboard because it was one of the first motherboards with SATA, and the SATA support on it is really strange and really iffy, and it could cause you to pull out your hair because of well, legacy OS shenanigans and weird combinations and that sort of stuff. Yeah, I'm not really getting into that at the moment or for now, but that's just something I might get into in the future. Yeah, well, I just hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching. Maybe it was useful in case you have a similar KVM switch or another KVM switch and you're experiencing this sort of issue. It might not be caused by the KVM switch itself, but you might just have bad luck with your monitor. So that was it for the moment. I hope you enjoyed it and thanks for watching. Bye bye.